Hello guys, on the end of 2012 I did a beer trade with Haribrew 69 and I have still two homebrews left and two commercial beers. In this video I'm going to taste these two homebrews that he shipped to me. Haribrew made a really nice letter to explain what he actually shipped. These two beers is made out of the same batch of beer, but he split that batch and dry hopped one half with the Challenger hops. And he wrote on the bottom of the letter, please feel free to use any part of this letter in your videos and to show the beers, etc. Well, you told me that the dry hop version maybe can smell of compost. I don't know if that's true, but I think we're just going to give it a try. I apologize. When you ship this bottles to me, one label came off the bottle and I put it something away. I didn't throw it away, but I put it on a safe place and I can't find it anymore for this video. He made two really nice labels. I don't know if you can see this. Let's take a look. Yeah. Brewed in Redford by Haribrew. The White Shield Bitter Clone 5.6 ABV. And these are half liter bottles. So I apologize that I don't know where the label is anymore, but there are two labels on these bottles. Let's give it a taste. I'm going to do it in the same video, two beers at once. First I'm going to test the normal one. He wrote on top of it, this is the dry hop version and this is the normal one. I guess bottles are pretty hard, so I expect a really, really good carbonation. And I'm not going to disturb the sediment on the bottle, but in this beer there is some sediment, so I think you bottled it with some prime sugar. Let's give it a try. I'm going to do the normal one in this duvel glass. Well, this is going to give a pour on camera, hopefully. Nice color. Hopefully you can see this. I will save a little bit for later. Look at that, really nice. Check the light. Wow, take a look at that color. Oh, my flashlight is broken, come on. Here we go. Wow, look at that color, that it's almost it's red brown copper color. Take a look at that head, really creamy head. I'm going to tell you, this is not a beer review, only a taste test. It looks very, very nice. There's a nice head on it, with big bubbles on the surface, and on top is a very creamy head. Take a look at that lacing on the glass. Smells nice. Malty, but also something else. Let's give it a taste. Oh wow. I really like this style of beer. Cheers, everyone. I forgot that. I really wanted to try this beer. This is really nice. I think I never had a bitter before. I know you guys out there drinking bitters more often. That's a really pretty beer. Tastes clean. No off flavors or smell. Really nice carbonation. Nice in bitterness. Wow. There's not much hop aroma to this one, but I expect there will be a lot of hop aroma on this one, and this is the dry hop version. I really like that one. It is really nice. There we go. We're going to pour this one, the dry hop version. Take a look at the carbonation. Oh, smoke coming off. They are well carbonated, Harry Brew. Wow, again. Going to save more for later. Take a look at that head. Wow. Can you see this? Why doesn't my flashlight work? Here we go. Very clear. Again. Big bubbles. Take a look. On top of the beer. A really nice creamy head. Focus. Creamy head on top. That looks really nice. Well, it's more or less the same beer. Let's see if I can detect different flavors and aroma. This is definitely no compost. Again, I cannot describe this aroma. I expected a really dark, heavy, wet hop aroma, but I smell something different. Mint isn't the right word. Tastes really nice. It's definitely not the smell of compost. Aroma is really nice on this one. Let's check this one again. Yeah, this one is different. I like the smell. Really, I do. Let's give it a taste. The taste is really different. Is this the Challenger hop? I don't know. I really like both beers. I can't tell you what I detect in this beer, but that will be, that's the only difference, I believe, that's the hops. And yeah, composed, no. There's a minty aroma on it. That's the best what I can do. No compost, that's for sure. And it seems that this one, yeah, that's true. Or not. I thought this one, the head on this one is a little bit more yellow, brown green than this one. It's hard to see on camera. I don't have good light here. Well, I'm sure I have two great beers to enjoy. Thank you, Harry Brew. Sorry, it's not a review, but I have to be honest with you. Not because I'm doing this video, I really like these two beers. Anise. Mint anise. No, I'm not going to give you more words to describe this beer. Well, maybe I'm totally wrong, but I like these beers. Harry Brew 69, thank you very much for the opportunity to try this these homebrews that you sent to me. If you didn't check Harry Brew 69's channel out, please do it. It's a really nice guy. He makes really nice, hilarious videos, and he's also a great brewer as well. So please check Harry Brew's website or channel, I have to say, YouTube channel. I still have the two commercial beers. I received a lot of comments on this Punk IPA. This one seems to be everyone's favorite. And Harry Brew, I hope you don't mind that I'm not going to make a video about this brews. There are better videos on YouTube if somebody wanted to see this beers or a review or something. I'm going to sit back, relax and enjoy this beers without a camera. Thank you very much for this beer. Well, this was it. I'm going to enjoy the rest of Harry Brew's homebrews. Take a look at the lasing again. Very nice color. I don't have the lighting in the brewery very great. Like Greg Toop always says, I'm double fisted. Yes, I am now, and I'm going to enjoy the rest of your homebrews. Cheers, everyone. Bye bye. Thanks for watching. Yeah, really like this one. Oh yeah, I forgot to mention this. I wanted to remove the camera from the tripod, and you already can feel there's alcohol in this homebrew. Really enjoy it. Cheers.